And when a person is strong and is willing to find the truth, also in an inner aspect, in an inner search, he will find many truths about himself. You can find who you really are. You can know who you were in different lifetimes. You can understand the real purpose that for it you've been sent to this world in this lifetime. You can understand exactly why you are involved in that relationship. You can understand exactly why you have those weaknesses, why you have those addictions. You can understand exactly where they are coming from. A regular person that doesn't investigate, that doesn't listen to himself, let's say about addictions. A person can be so addicted to certain things and like he's asking himself again and again, why in the world I'm falling to the same place over and over again and again? I already realized, I saw so many times, been clarified for me more than 100%, more than 100,000 times already that it's not good for me, that it's not healing me, that it's not building me, that it's destroying me, that I hate myself for that, that I disappoint my beloved ones because of that. Again and again and again. And again I'm falling to the same loop, I'm falling to the same pit. And why is it happening to me? A person that will not ask, a person that will not be willing and strong and stubborn to find the truth will be stuck in that loop forever. He will never find the power and the solution to go out from it. And even if he will go to experts, and even if he will go to professionals, and even if he will find himself clean for 5 years, for 10 years, when a horrible crisis might take place in his life, he can find himself in the same place or even lower. There is no guarantee. Until what? Until you make a real root canal and you fix things in their root. Now, how are you going to reach the root? How are you going to remember what took place in your life when you were 3 years old? Or maybe in a different lifetime. How will you remember? It's 30 years ago. You don't remember. Your emotional body worked so hard to deny that experience. Like you made a huge work on hiding it and forgetting all about it. And cut those relationships already and moved to another state. And you don't have a clue where it started. Because you built those walls of separation from that experience. Because it was so traumatic. And sometimes it's even earlier in a different lifetime. So how in the world are you going to remember something that took place 300, 700 years ago in a different body, in a different world? Like, how can I know? If you try to investigate over there, go to some mekubal, or going to someone that will read in the cards for you, I don't know, speak to the dead or something, it won't work. Because of the distance. The answer will not come because really it's too far to catch. But if you will make one step toward that place, if you will make a small investigation today, not finding everything about what happened back then, just you're going to listen to your voice, so you're going to make one step, but you will also going to build yourself while making that step. If now I'm going to open your eyes and going to show you exactly why you're so terrified from relationships, why you can't open yourself emotionally, if I'm going to show you the reason you're going to be so terrified from the reason, you will come back to that moment that you've been hurt so badly that you will close yourself exactly like you closed yourself when you were 3 or 7 or 300 years ago. You will block your emotions because you won't be able to deal with the stress. Why? There was a reason why you closed yourself when you were young. What was the reason? When you've been hurt. What was the reason? The reason was that it was too hard. That the pain was too severe, too hard to deal with. You didn't have the tools, the armor to stand in front of that difficulty and to face it. You never had the tools. You've been abused, you've been hurt, you've been violated. That's what that killed you. That's what that destroyed you. So, if I'll take you there, you're going to be destroyed again. Because you haven't built yourself since then. Not in that aspect. Because in that aspect, like we said, you're denying it. You're still hiding it. You're plastering like everything is good. But you know about yourself that you have a problem. if you're going to make one step toward that direction and then check your stability and deal with that one understanding, one deeper thought that you have on that subject, it will give you the power in one day from now, in 1 week from now, to make another step to that direction. And when you'll feel the ground shaking under your leg, under your legs, and you'll be scared, if you will decide, okay, I'm not making another progress. I just want to stabilize myself over here. I want to work on that level. Here I'm standing. And you're going to work on yourself in that shaky level of yours. You're going to try to be a little bit more open in the relationship. In an aspect, in one aspect, you're going to try to work on yourself. One less cigarette. Well, at least not when I'm totally angry. I don't know, choosing a different kind of drug, lighter drugs, something, depends on the addiction. Gonna try to talk to a friend about it, maybe not an expert, maybe not a therapist, maybe not your children, I don't know, but not your parents. Okay, maybe not to go all the way, but you will make one progress about it. You will be able to admit with yourself in front of the mirror that you do have a weakness. And you're going to accept it. And you're going to work on yourself to stabilize yourself in that second step that you made in your progress, process of progress. The English breaks your teeth as well, all the time. The only one that is suffering. So, when you progress based on your powers, means that you are aware to your power. And you try and you check yourself. Is it too much? Is it taking too long? Am I still happy? Or that it's killing me and I must go back a few steps and then to re-prepare myself, check myself, organize myself for that experience again. Then by that wise preparation, you will build the vessel to finish that journey and to come to the roots of your soul, to know exactly who you are and how you've been hurt and how it's affecting you until today. And a person cannot be healed from addictions. A person cannot be healed from emotional pain unless he will work on himself with honesty, one step after the other. If you will try to find quick solutions, you're not going to find them. Even they're not going to help you. Even if you will go to righteous people and to Mikubalim and to I don't know who, to famous people, it's not going to help you. It's not going to help you. Like an inner process, building your honesty, building and developing your self-awareness, reconnecting to your true self, and using the tools that have been given to you naturally by the Creator. He gave you tools to solve every problem in your life. And He will be there for you when you will be honest. A person that is lying, the blessing of heaven is not hovering above him. He cannot enjoy the light of heaven because he is plastering and hiding the truth. And the Creator himself, he is the truth. And in this world, certain things are real things. Like that example, this is a wall. Okay, it's the truth. It's not white. That's the truth. That is a face of Hashem. The fact that the wall is not white and that it is a wall is a face of heaven. Hashem, the Creator, decided to show, to present himself in that truth. Now, to deny it, to say, no, it's not a wall, it's my husband and he's green, by doing that, you are lying and you're erasing the existence of the Creator. You're making up a whole different story that does not have no foundations, does not have no roots in the truth. So you erase the name of heaven, the name of the Creator that created that to be a wall, that created it not to be white for a reason, for no reason. You did it for your own fears. You did it for your own lusts, for your own desires, because you wanted to look wise. You wanted people to like you. You wanted to achieve something. You want to sell it to some. You had your evil, your foreign reason to bend and to twist the truth, even a simple truth like that. You don't need to twist the Torah and to twist the Gemara to become a liar. You can just lie about your condition. You can just lie about your reality. You can just lie about the direction that the person should take in the street. And by doing that, you are disconnecting yourself from the source of blessing that is the Creator Himself, that He is the God of truth. So if you want to be blessed, the only way to do it is to connect yourself to the truth, not in the high levels, just in the most simple levels of your life.
The world does not exist. Because Olam Milshon Ne'elem, the world is just blocking the light of truth. The world called Alma Deshika, world of light, is just a fake. We're just inside of an illusion. It's just a fake. We're just inside of an illusion.
We're just inside of an illusion.